Is there a spiritual reason to engage in food, or in walking in nature, or in listening to lectures, or in dancing in a party? In the sense that that in the general sense, sex is just one of the activities that that humans have as possibilities, and almost all human beings, definitely including me, have to go through most of the important activities of human life, human journey, because we need to go through them. It's like a school. You need to learn. You need to fully experience. Otherwise, you can never, you cannot move to the highest stair without going through all the stairs. There are very few, very rare individuals who came to the world without needing to do any of this. And we know some of them. They came enlightened. Most of us need to go through the school to come, wake up every morning, study, fall in love, be disappointed, cry, enter horrible sexual experiences, be traumatized. They have addictions to food and fight to overcome them. All these are necessary for us to complete our understanding. Our understanding cannot derive only from practices. They are from spiritual wisdom. They need to derive from direct engagement with life and also pain and suffering. To never suffer, you need to go through suffering. That's obvious. But with spirituality, you can at least shorten the degree of required suffering. You see, you can minimize the process of suffering. So, do we need to go through physical sex? Most probably for most of us, yes. We have to go through physical sex, and because it teaches us. It teaches us on many levels. But do we need to engage in physical sex for the rest of our life? Definitely not. Absolutely not. At a certain point, you understand sex. Sex has given you what it could give you. You see? And then, again, if you move through the ladder, if you progress, at a certain point, any human experience will exhaust itself, will reach its peak. You will look at it and you say, okay, I get it. I don't need now to again take off my clothes, do all the mess, and go through all the mess and kisses, all that, all the exchanging body fluids, you know, all these things. Okay, I got it. I was in love. I was in love. I know what it means to touch. I know what orgasm is. It's enough. And but it should never come as a result of a pure ideal. Mm-hmm. It's not because you think highly of yourself. It's not ego. It's just like a toddler. Toddlers, you know, they have pacifiers. They walk all day, or they have blankets, right? They walk with a blanket, something like that. And then at a certain point, they throw the blanket or the pacifier, and they don't ever think about it. So in the same way, you reach a point in which a certain human experience is exhausted. It's like you understood. That's what it's all about. And it's no longer suppression. It's not repression. It's not self-denial. It's not that you're against pleasures. You just can't do it. You don't need to do it. So this is... And this, by the way, applies to many other events in our life, not only that. It's a school, but you can graduate from the school.